Yo, what's up? It's Danny and Jace, and we're from the band Bury Tomorrow. Yeah, so the tour is going to be absolutely insane. It's a Black Flame tour. It's going to be a real celebration for us, for the album, for our fans to get to see us in a headline capacity again. We've been doing a lot of festivals over this year, whether that's European or also UK. And for us, it's going to be a real good time to really smash a lot of that album and for people to see it live and in the way it was intended, you know, for our band.
Yeah, we're a live band through and through, so.
That's it. For us, when we write a song, it's written with the live setting in mind. So that tour is going to be insane. It's going to be awesome. Yeah, so July 13th, we release our album. For us, it's a really exciting time. Like, this is the most nerve-wracking kind of time because you've got it there, and it's just an impatient time being in a band. It's like the worst bit when you've got the record and you just want everybody under the sun to hear it, you know. And
you got to pick singles. It's really difficult to pick singles.
So. Woe is us, really. So it's a really tough job, you know. But yeah, it's really cool. We're really excited for people to hear it. It's along the same lines as what we've done prior, but I think really amped to the next level. It's a very mature album for us. The production's amazing. We're just absolutely on a high to be able to get this album out there, you know. I think I'm most looking forward to playing, we played Knife of Gold, and like, Knife of Gold is one of them that we wrote. It's a heavy, heavy track on the album, and for us, I think that was the song that we went, yeah. You know what, like, if we're going to release anything for people to hear, like, as a live setting, that's the track to hear.
And My Revenge?
My Revenge, we're very excited as well.
Yeah, it's got the, you know.
It's a real like festival guy.
It's a real fist pumper.
That's it. Pretty much, it's just, that's the best way to describe it. It's just a fist pumping song. It's an old school kind of metal vibe as well. So it's got that real driving feel to it. So yeah, I mean, and also every song, you know, and we have to say it, we are very excited to be able to play this song. Like,
the first festival I ever attended was, I think it was with the band.
Yeah.
I never had enough money to go to a festival before this. So then I was like, oh sweet, I get a free ticket.
Yeah, no,
I want to say
Sonosphere, maybe then.
Yeah, big one. Yeah, probably Sonosphere. Yeah.
Yeah, I think mine was cool. I think mine was the same. Like, I was very young when I joined the band, as was Jay, and like, for us, like, we are very lucky in that the first time we played some of these major festivals, certainly Download and Sonosphere and those kind of high level festivals, we were in an established band, so it's quite lucky in that sense. But yeah, I think Sonosphere was my first back in 2010, I think it was. So my favourite thing about festivals is always the weather.
Well, today it's quite nice.
No, it is, and you know, for us, I think we're very lucky to be able to play outside of the UK a lot at festivals, and we've had a really good summer so far of absolutely amazing picturesque festivals. But yeah, it's just the vibe. There's a great vibe at festivals. People are all here to have a good time. All here to kind of see the bands that they love, but also see the bands that they've never heard of before. You know, we spoke to a lot of people today at our signing and walking around, and that they absolutely haven't seen us before or never heard of us before. And that's, you know, that's the part of the part and parcel of playing a festival, is that you gain new fans. You know, so it's a huge part of it. Funniest thing that's ever happened to me on a festival is I have walked out. It was Vainstream Festival. It's a televised festival as well, so it's got big screens and all that. And I walked out, giving it my all, and I stood in front of the monitors, and then I stood back over the monitors and caught my like foot and just went straight down onto my back. And I sung the entire first song on my back.
You did it great, though.
I mean, I looked amazing.
It was
like, and I did like a perfect finish, you know.
You fall like a swan, mate.
It was beautiful. Like I mean, it's now my stage move. I actually now do that I definitely don't. That's not a thing. Stage move made me almost gag in my mouth when I said that. But yeah, no, that's one of my. That's probably one of the most awkward moments of my life. But it was great. It was fun. You know. Festival essentials.
Warm, man.
Festival essentials. Tell me.
Festival essentials: a tent and a sleeping bag if you are camping. If you're not camping,
beer.
Then I would say you know, like a walk-around charger.
Like one of those bricks. Bricks, like yeah, that. You definitely need...
That in this day and age, that's like...
Right, that's like gold dust.
Keep your Instagram story going, then you need that.
And that's very important. And so, if you want friends, it's also a really good way of making friends, because if you're walking around and you're like, I got no friends, but I got a charging brick.
Tinder?
You wait.
What's Tinder like a download? Is it working? Does it work at festivals?
You what? That's not a festival essential.
No, but it's just, it's in the festival essential. Well, it's not in it. I didn't say phone, did I? I should have said phone.
To survive a festival, how do we survive a festival? I think you've got to be up for being completely disgusting for the entirety of it.
Yeah.
I think if you've got any kind of notion against smell or dirt or mud or dust or just being generally a horrific human being, I think that's it. Like, that's the only way you're going to survive is by understanding that everybody's
smiling, consistently smile, because if you do it long enough, you'll be happy in the
and
end, right?
Carry sun cream. Like,
there's so much to smile at festivals, so
I think of survival
carry
tips.
Sun
you
cream.
Need you need a sun cream. Like, let's do it right now. Carry sun cream.
What if it rains?
Melanoma is a real thing. Like, you need to protect yourself against skin cancer. Yeah, I see too many people, I'm not even joking, like, you see too many people walking around a festival, they are burnt. That's irresponsible.
Yeah. No, I mean, we've turned a corner here, but you're right, this is a serious
We've now become a public service announcement. Please carry sun cream. Please.